program do not necessarily reflect or represent those of the owners, management, or advertisers of Pacific Telestations, Inc. This message has been brought to you by the stations of KUAM.
You're watching Buzz with Jess Luha.
Good evening, Guam. I'm Jess Luhan. Welcome to this evening's show. Exciting show tonight with Attorney Curtis Vanderbilt, who's representing the estate of Rita Aquino Salas in a class action lawsuit recently filed in federal court, alleges that Gov Guam illegally collected real estate property taxes from landowners whose property have been acquired for public use. Public Law 22-73, a local statute enacted in 1994, mandated that Gov Guam to compensate landowners who weren't paid when all or portions of their property were taken and used for to build public roads, access easements, and public utilities. Attorney Curtis Vanderbilt. Good evening, Curtis. How are you doing?
Good evening, Jess. Good. How are you?
Real good. You know, I think it was last week when RevenTax published the delinquent names of people who owe taxes on their property. How does this affect them? Because, you know, when you owe the government, if you don't pay on time, government's ready to foreclose on you. In cases like this, government over the years have owed people, and those same properties may fall into this lawsuit, and it hasn't been carved out by the government, right?
Yes, I mean, this is a problem that really goes to the core of property ownership. Mm-hmm. In a declaration filed in another case that tried to raise the same issue in January of 2013, the Department of Land Management indicated that they could not determine which property was the subject of the lawsuit. Mm-hmm. And that really is disingenuous. It's just not honest, because the Inspector General was able to investigate the land ownership on Guam, mm-hmm. and identify substantial portions of property that were subject to having been mm-hmm. used for public purpose or restricted use for public purpose of private land, and no compensation had ever been provided. Mm-hmm. And if the Inspector General of the Department of the Interior for the United States government in its oversight of Guam mm-hmm. could identify those properties, then it just simply isn't true mm-hmm. that the government of Guam can't do it. And you know, these injustices have existed for more than two mm-hmm. decades mm-hmm. since the law mm-hmm. was passed. The Public Law 22-73, it was a product of the 1993 Guam legislature. This was something that was overridden after a veto message from then-Governor Joe Atta mm-hmm. said, if we have to do this, it will bankrupt the government. Mm-hmm. We can't do it. And yet the legislature, that was back when there were 21, 18 of the 21 senators mm-hmm. said, no, this has to be done. Every single governor mm-hmm. since mm-hmm. has not done what the public law requires.
As a matter of fact, when they first voted in the public law, it was 21. It was 21 voted in favor of the bill. When it came to the governor's desk for signature, it was vetoed. It was overwritten by, again, 18 votes when they were 21 senators. And when we go back to this again, as a matter of fact, the Inspector General, that was part of the testimony, and that became Public Law 22-73. The Director of Land Management, I think it was Frank Castro, I think, at the time, that testified in favor of this as well. So was, I think, a lot of the mayors have testified, most especially the mayors whose villages have been, you know, if not 90-100% maybe of their residents over there are affected by this as well. So when we're looking at this, Curtis, again, what kind of land is affected and has to be compensated?
Well, there's different kinds of land that's affected. For example, in the Inspector General's report, which mm-hmm. is 93-I-226, which was issued November 1992, mm-hmm. It identified that there were 20.2 miles of Route 4 and Route 4A that were used, that were the private land of the people abutting the road. It was their land that was being used, but it had never been taken properly by the government and never compensated for. And so the people were being taxed on that land because they were being taxed on the lot as it the lot is recorded at the Department of Land Management, which is inclusive of the part of the lot which the road goes over. So, and it's not just that 20.2 miles. There's further concern. The IG's report went on to describe that there were other parcels that had been taken, and none of the property had been compensated for, including portions of land which were designated by the Guam Master Plan, the 1966 Guam Master Plan, as being subject to future potential rights of way, and which included 839,000 square meters of private land with an estimated value of $124.4 million. And the government made it so that anybody who owned land that was in these lots that had these separate designations could not use the land for any purpose that was inconsistent with the master plan. So if the proposed master plan was that that property was going to be used for road widening, you couldn't put it to use, like building a structure on it, because that the government of Guam would never give you the permit. And so these people have been affected by this public law for well over 20 years.
But now, Curtis, but it's not only the public law. I mean, we're dealing with constitutional issues here that, that says you can't do a taking without compensation.
Well, that's exactly what the Inspector General said in his letter of November 30, 1992, when he transmitted his report to the government of Guam and to the Guam legislature. He says, our audit further disclosed the government of Guam took a reserve for its own use, private property, without legal due process and without landowner compensation. These actions are contrary to the Organic Act of Guam and the U.S. Constitution. I mean, it's, again, it comes back to, you know, historically, the government of Guam has tried to stress through the creation of the Ancestral Lands Commission, that property is very sacred to the Chamorro people. And so they've created a means of giving additional compensation to people who have already been compensated for their land, because they said what compensation they got wasn't enough. But they don't even want to pay people that they took land from. I mean, this isn't additional compensation. This is just not compensating them at all. And when we had the last election for Attorney General, the Attorney General indicated that she supported, during the campaign process, she supported this public law.
No,
filed a lawsuit, and now the AG's office is opposing it.
I remember. I interviewed the Attorney General. As a matter of fact, there were hot issues at the time. This was one of them. This class action lawsuit, as well as the medicinal marijuana, these were the hot issues that, again, that either the sitting Attorney General at the time will have to continue to deal with, or the Attorney General who finally won, Liz Barrett Anderson, will have to contend with. And she, she said that she was in support, that, you know, these are things that the government owes and needs to start finding ways to compensate the people for all the, I guess, these years of injustice to them.
Unfortunately, even though the conscience of the government created Public Law 22-73, and contrary to all of the reasons offered that it would have financial disastrous consequences, still, by an overwhelming majority, said, no, this is a wrong that needs to be made mm-hmm. right. The government has done everything it can not to do mm-hmm. what Public Law 22-73 said.
You know, I got to take a break with this, but I don't know how the government can continue to do that when not only public law says you have to do so, and the Constitution, in which I think we're still under and still mandated to follow, says you're not permitted to do that. A government cannot do that.
and so does the Organic yeah. Act, and I mean, which is the Constitution for Guam.
Anyway, I got to take a quick break. We'll be right back. We'll be talking about, how are we going to deal with this, and who's eligible to come on?